This is a video about Filament. If you dabbled with Filament forms before, you might know that you can set one form field's value based on the value of another field, like the classic title to slug example. But what about file uploads? Wouldn't it be cool if you could upload a file in the background and then show it in the form based on another form field's value, like for example an URL to fetch the favicon? When I finally figured this out, my fiancé gave me a little gift for stop pacing around the apartment. I'll open it at the end of the video. Hi, I'm Sylvan. I create websites and web apps for a living, and I happen to run a few Filament applications in production. Here we have an ordinary Filament form with a website URL, title, and a favicon file upload. So, if we add my website here, nothing happens. First of all, we're gonna set the title based on the website URL. So in order to do this, we need to add live, and let's do this on blur, and then we need the I think I have it copied here. Yes. All right. So we use the after state updated method, and we add set and state, and then we create a title from the URL. Let's have a look. I'll reload this real quick. And then if I go here and say laravel.com, as you can see, the title is automatically filled out and formatted, but that's not what we're actually here for. So I thought maybe we could set the favicon as easily as the title. What could we do here? To fetch the favicon, I'm going to use the Favicon Fetcher package by Ash Allen, and I'll leave a link in the description below. I already have it installed, so let's go here. First, we fetch. Then we fetch the largest, then the favicon content is what actually gets the favicon from the URL, and then we want to set the file. Let's give it a try. Reload, I go here and say Sylvan Hagen, that's my name. And not much happens. All right, let's see, maybe debug bar has something in it for us. All right, it's trying this. Oh, as you can see, it tried to add the contents of the favicon path. So that's not what we want. Let's see how it does it if we actually upload something. Let's take this image, for example. All right. Back to debug bar, and what does it show us? All right, it creates a UUID and a temporary uploaded file. What if we try to create a temporary uploaded file ourselves? So I created this function real quick, and first we want to save the file to a temporary location, get the MIME type, create an uploaded file, and put it into the Livewire temporary directory in the storage. All right. And then we simply recreate a UUID, make that to string so we can add it in an array, and then return the temporary uploaded file. Here we'll do this self. This file. All right, let's see if this might work. So really reload and laravel.com. The title is set. And what do we have here? All right, we created the temporary uploaded file. We have it here. But no luck on this. Filament is using FilePond for file uploads. And after a brief discussion with Stefan Zweifel, a fellow developer here in Switzerland, he gave me the idea that I could possibly download the image, create a base 46 version of it, and send it as an event. I tried this, it did not actually work, but based on this idea, thank you, Stefan, I figured out a way to do it. So here's what we're gonna try. We're gonna try and download the file like we did already, and then send the temporary URL, the preview URL that Livewire creates for file uploads, to the browser and trigger an upload using the FilePond API. Let's try it. All right, we will not be needing this, but instead we want to dispatch an event. Livewire dispatch file uploaded, or let's call it at favicon. And let's add Livewire here. Livewire. All right, now we should have it here. We can dispatch this. We can still set the title. Good. Now we need to listen to this. So let's use the extra Alpine attributes for this. Not the, that's not our event. Now we have this. We get the FilePond thingy from the window and find the FilePond root. This gives us access to the FilePond API. First, we want to remove any files that are there, and then we want to add a file. And the info from the file comes from our event here. The next thing we have to do is to change this method to return a temporary URL. All right, so now we should get a temporary signed route that will download the file for us. Let's try it out. All right, reload. And again, let's take my site. Let's try something else. I think we need to make Alpine listen on the window object. Window. Let's try this again. Let's keep Josh as an example. Yay! Look, that seems to work. All right. But now if we change this to Sylvan Hagen. Okay. Yeah, so probably while setting the title, it will cancel this. Let's try this with a timeout. Maybe that will work. All right, and now let's add Christoph. And that works. That seems to be working. Cool. Can I save this now? All right. Nice. And that's it. There you have it. We downloaded the file, created a temporary file URL, dispatched an event, listened to the event in Alpine, and then take the event detail and upload the file again. It's probably not the super nicest solution, but it works for small files. If you're gonna use this in production, you will probably want to add some more safety nets and checks, and you might wanna add a loading indicator because it's gonna take a second. If you find this video useful, please like and subscribe. Now to the gift.
Wow, what a surprise. Nice.
If you found a better solution, please let me know in the comments below and I'll send you this hat.